So I want to show you the high temperatures as you head across the entire state of Oregon yesterday. We saw those crystal clear blue skies, but we've still been stuck under a little bit chillier of an air mass. So high temperatures yesterday got up to 68 degrees. Now, this time of year, that's actually quite a bit above average. We're talking a good 5-6 degrees above average, but it is cooler than will be any other day this week. 69 in Corvallis, 72 up in Portland. Head further south. Warm there as well, 73 in Roseburg and 80 in Medford. Head over to Central Oregon, low to mid 60s yesterday, and the South Coast, a sign of what is headed our direction, 83 degrees for the high temperature there yesterday. And today is going to be sort of that first day for us in the Willamette Valley and in the Umpqua Basin, even Central Oregon and the coast, that we start to see those temperatures warming up. We're seeing completely clear skies across Western Oregon this morning as high pressure has moved in. Temperatures not as chilly here at the start of the day. We've only dropped down to 43 degrees out at the Eugene Airport. Also, taking a look at the dew point, down to 35. Because there's a big separation between those two numbers, that tells us that the air is pretty dry, the high pressure is doing its thing. We also see that our winds are out of the north. When winds come out of the north this time of year, and generally means a drier weather is on the way, and that's definitely the case. So you can see that jet stream is headed up into central Canada, nice little ridge of high pressure overhead. What that does is sets up a sinking atmosphere, clears out all the clouds, gives us that full sunshine, which generally does warm us up. But we're also going to start to see some heat moving up from the south at the same time. What's going to happen is we're going to see a thermal trough, a heat low developing here over Northern California, starting today. That's going to make its way north over the coming days and bring in that warm air with it. Also bring in some nice offshore winds, which help to warm us up even further. Just to give you an idea of how warm it's going to be, down in Central California today, they're looking at mid-90s near Stockton. Even Redding will likely get up to 90 degrees there today. So on PrecisionCast, you can see again those clear skies here this morning. As we head into this evening, may see just a few high cirrus clouds move overhead. Nothing all that significant. Definitely staying dry. And then as we head into Friday and this weekend, that's when we're really going to see that high pressure doing its thing, that heat low moving up from the south, and we will definitely see the warmest weather that we have seen so far in 2013, and for many of us, the first days in the 80s. So for the coast, highs will be back to the low to mid 60s. Sunny and mild, and those winds holding from the north at 5 to 15 miles per hour. This weekend, those winds will likely get even stronger from the north and from the northeast, and that'll bring those temperatures up into the low 70s by Saturday, upper 60s Sunday, and then Monday, we'll see those winds shift back around to the southwest, and that will cool us down a bit along the coast, down into the upper 50s. The Umpqua Basin looking at low 80s already today, sunny and warm, and again, this sticks with us all weekend. Your high temperatures getting back into the mid 80s by Sunday. The Cascades, mid-60s, snow level clear up to 12,000 feet, low 70s, even in the foothills. Low to mid-70s in central Oregon. And as we head into this weekend, low to mid-70s there as well. Few thundershowers may start to move in Tuesday and Wednesday. And for the valley, mid-70s today, so it begins. 77 Friday, 80 Saturday, up to 82 degrees on Sunday.
Just not normal.
Not normal at all. Yes.